Hey guys, Dante here, and welcome back to my channel, The Burgle Slot. And welcome to Inktober once again. Today is October 18th. And today is track. And as per usual, we will be sticking with a kind of mad scientist laboratory theme for these drawings. Whatever that may mean. So let's see what we got. Alright, raise the spooky volume a little bit. Okay, what to do for today? Usually I try to at least look at what the prompt is early in the day, if I could spend the rest of the day, just contemplating what I want to do with it. Today's no exception, but once again, I'm kind of not sure. And we've had pictures of slippery creatures trying to get wrestled, creatures in boxes getting fed. So I don't feel like I want to do like an actual trap, like an actual like cage or some type catching someone or catching a creature. I've been watching a lot of Among Us, so I'm getting some like. I'm getting some trapped in a corridor kind of vibes. Maybe I could do something like that. And for those of you who will be watching these in the soon future, I hope you're happy. I stopped watching Deadpool 2 for the first time. I had to turn off the TV to do this today. So you better be happy. That would be funny, just like a scientist, really clean cut, just stuck in a random bear trap. I'm just so tired of drawing people in trench coats and like lab coats and everything. What to do? Because there's so many things. There's like literal traps, like things that catch you. There's people who are trapped in a situation. I can think of a ton of drawings for that. Yeah, exactly. Like catching experiments, catching like creatures or people for like unknown horrors deep in the lab. I could do a monkey, like, strapped into a chair with, like, electrodes in his head. But it doesn't really encapsulate trap. It's more like, I don't know, it just comes off more depressing than anything else. That sounds like a fun type of like sci-fi gun. GPG! And you positively absolutely gotta kill every guinea pig in the room. Because I got a random playlist of like, it's not one continuous video, it's like 12 different videos. And I'm just waiting for the videos, the music videos that are playing, the spooky music. I'm just waiting for them to get interrupted by like a freaking insurance commercial. Just completely breaks the mood. Okay. I have myself an idea. Not sure how well it will work, but I have an idea. Time to pull out our art model. What angle would it be at? I guess it would be more of a low angle, okay. So we're going to start by drawing some individual absolutely cowering in the corner. Freaking pen, come on, don't dry up on me now. There we go. I just have a basic shape. Basic form of someone just on the floor, freaking out because things are not going his way. Now we're gonna do some cool, big, big detail stuff right here. What we got is this man trapped in a corridor alongside some creature. Not as a dramatic an angle as I wanted, but we'll work with it. Draw some heavy shadows and everything. Let's do bright shadows this way, heavy shadows on the left side of him. So channel freeform, I don't know what it's called anymore. But basically where they show like all the like Halloween films, you know, all the family friendly ones. So talking Adam's Family and of course Hocus Pocus, they're in full swing right now. going through all, you know, all that catalog of like family-friendly 90s, early 2000 movies. And I love the Adams Family movie. I never watched Like There Is No Show. I have no like no nostalgia for it, but the movie, I love the movie. It's such a bizarre yet fun movie. It has, you know, some of my favorite actors in it. Christopher Lloyd, can't go wrong with Christopher Lloyd. The Mamushka. This weekend was extremely non-productive. I just crashed and slept in far more than I should have. Man, I always pull myself out of it to make sure I get these done because, you know, that's my goal, to do these. But damn, like I felt like I could have been way, way more productive this weekend. So much more productive. So it's basically coming down the hallway along with our eponymous creature here. So I'll make sure I get like some good floor shadows and everything.
So what's the story here? With your lab assistant that bit off more than you could chew? Is he the evil scientist that just... this creature just got loose and now he's paying for it? Like, what's the real story here?
Fine brush, I meant to grab the medium. Where's the medium? Medium brush. Casting this long shadow. There we go. Just want to sharpen up these edges because the brush pens I have, the edges aren't as sharp as they need to be. They'll cover good ground, but they won't capture the sharpness I want. Here's a good one. There's a good one. I forget that separate from my, little art notebook here. I have a whole slew of pens on the side. I forgot that those are the newer ones. So I can use those to get, you know, those heavy black lines. That's a nice sharp brush right there. See, I leave these next to my art table for whenever I do work on my comic work, which is far in between projects right now. I have all the new stuff right next to me. The stuff I carry on my person are more like, you know, just on the go stuff. This to kind of fade this foot into the fade this leg somewhat into the shadows. Not perfect, but we'll add some more cross hatching in a moment. Oh, nothing like that solid black ink. When it comes out, the perfect solid, like opaque level you want. Oh, it's so satisfying. You fool! You forgot to feed him. He's on a strict, no sugar diet. You've damned us all. Hey, Oak Punch. Good to see you. Did you guys ever meet up to do the shovel game? I was trying to stay up late to see if I could catch you guys acting like fools. You gotta cut back on that cocaine. I know what caffeine is a code word for. It's okay, man. You have a problem. As long as you admit it, we're here for you. I ain't got no problem. I could quit whenever I want. And I don't want to quit. Does the guy look kind of Asian to you? I wasn't aiming for Asians, but I feel like he looks kind of Asian. Maybe it's a simple little comb over hair that I gave him. What do you mean the view bots? Like you can't just hit chat and remove the general chat? Or you're talking about the stuff I put in there? That's a little out of focus. Just want to adjust the camera a little bit. Well, if I, like I said, I don't know what that does. Like, if I do type in mod and your username, what does that do? Does that give you, like, certain abilities to, like, I don't know, drop in pictures or something? Like, what exactly is the purpose of that? freaking corners curling up. I hate when it does that. Well, as of right now, there's no one that needs to be banned, so thank you for the offer to moderate. But at the moment, you know, no major need for it. When I hit it big and I start getting attacked by billions of people telling me to buy their shoes or some BS account, you will be the first man I contact. Now, granted, this is more trapped, as in someone is trapped, as opposed to being a trap. But then again, maybe it was a trap. Maybe he was lured into this little area, and Big Bad Dino, whatever it is, with his little T-Rex arms, is going, yes, yes, just like I planned. In fact, just in my head, Ken, he's this big, snarling, horrific animal. Everyone's terrified of him. But when a perspective changes to his point of view, he sounds like freaking Megatron from Beast Wars. It's like everyone's terrified of this giant, roaring, snarling, drooling creature. But when he's like, from his typical, like, you know, slasher film villain point of view, you just hear him monologuing as Megatron the entire time. Alrighty then, I think that's it for tonight, guys. As always, thank you for joining me, guys. It's always a pleasure to have more people in the chat to talk back and forth with. But yeah, that is Trap. He is in a trap. Is he in a hallway? Is he in an air duct? Because, you know, in sci-fi films, of course, all air ducts are built to handle the weight of a full-grown man. But whatever he is not in a good space right now. Just another day in Lab 37. You know, it goes into the notebook, it gets put into an envelope. That envelope then goes up one of those old-fashioned suction tubes, and you have no idea where it goes. And that's how they handle their reports, their incident reports. It's like it's a standard incident report. But anyway, once again, guys, I am Dante. Like, favorite, share, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And I'll see you in the future. Later.